Sukhaya karmani karoti loko. Sukhaya karmani karoti loko. Gauriya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanto Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that whole world busy to serve this material body. Sukhaya karmani karoti loko. Why people working? To get some facility. To get some enjoyment. Yadi anandaho na sat. If there is no ananda, who is going to lead family life? Who is going to live in this material world? Jodi ananda na sad. Jodi ananda na sad. If there is no ananda, ko jivita me chati. Who is going to live? Who like to live? Gauriya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that the whole world is busy to serve this material body. They cannot understand anything about soul. They are less interested about soul. They only can see this material body to get some facility for this material body and mind. This is their target. This is their target. Whole world is running behind it, like blind. Actually, point is that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati wanted to speak what Gauriyamat want to do. What Gauriyamat want to do, that Prabhupada was interested to preach this. To erase the current perverted tide of this fanatic world is seemingly unpleasant duty of Gauriyamat. Whole world running behind sub maya, illusion. You cannot check anybody, everybody running behind. In Bhagavad Gita, on those days I was discussing all about what is the danger. Yesterday I was thinking, Salpamopi asya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. What is that danger? That we should think. Whole world busy to get some facility of mind and body, this much. And all demigods there. Somebody going to worship Shivji Maharaj. Somebody going to worship Kartik. Somebody going to worship Ganapati Maharaj. Somebody going to worship Durga Ji. You see, they are busy. Has some reason. Those who are Panchopasak, Panchopasak, no? Surjo, Ganapati, Shakti, this way, Durga, this way, Panchopasak. They like to demand, they deserve that we are Vaishnav. But Prabhupada speaking, no, not at all. They are not Vaishnav. More or less, they are Mayavadi. They are not at all Vaishnav. If they are going to worship Vishnu, Tattva from heart at all, they are going to worship Vishnu, Tattva from heart, they are Vaishnav. Vishnu Tattva, if they are going to worship Vishnu Tattva, then Vaishnav. Vaishnav, this word coming from Vishnu, all pervading Supreme Lord, covering Krishna also, because Krishna is the Supreme Lord. Those people, they are interested to do serve Ganapati Maharaj. Ganapati Maharaj, what is the meaning of Ganapati Maharaj? What is the meaning of Ganapati? What is the meaning of What is the meaning of Ganapati? Ganapati means leader. Leader of this society is Ganapati. Ganapati, leader. So, they are busy to worship Ganapati Maharaj to get some facility, financial facility, this, that. Ah, Ganapati Maharaj can give a leadership over so many people, those ministers. They are getting control over huge population. They want to reason. Somebody asking, why Ganapati Maharaj riding on a rat? So fat man riding on a rat can... Why? Why Ganapati Maharaj so fat? Ride on a rat can die instead. No. There is nice philosophy there. Very nice. What is that? Actually, Ganapati Maharaj, rat is very small, mouse. Mouse is very small. Rat or mouse? Mouse means small, a rat is big. Okay, I can take a rat. So small. All common people, they are so small, with so small power, they are going to back the leader. Follow what I say. Those small people, they have small power. But if they boat, one by one, they cast boat, then they together making that leader high. So the philosophy is that they are riding on a rat. Because common people are compared with rat, very low power. And Ganapati means leader. He is standing on the power of all common people. That is why Ganapati Maharaj. Somebody is saying, Maharaj, why Lakshmi Devi riding owl? Owl cannot see properly. Lakshmi Devi is so wealth, riches. Lakshmi Devi having so riches. Why Lakshmi Devi? We can get a horse or car, big chariot. Why riding on owl? What is the reason? But the philosophy is very practical. Why Lakshmi Devi riding on an owl? Owl? Why? Because if Lakshmi Devi coming in your room, at your room, to give you riches, then automatically is that man become blind. Cannot see Vaishnava or Brahman. Oh, useless. I am leader. That's why. Follow. They become blind automatically. I can show you. They couldn't manage their daily bread. Now they become Maharaj, billions of dollars. They deserve, I am from rich family. I know. But I am from poor family. Follow. They become blind. They cannot see. They insult Guru Vaishnava. They are useless. They don't know. Dhano made, vidya made, Vaishnava na chine. Out of, you know, educational power, out of, you know, financial power, they don't understand who is Vaishnava, who is Brahman. Useless. But Krishna Chaitanya, they always, Ramchandra, they always give honor to Brahman, Vaishnava, Rishi. This is the reason. Then why people, they are worshipping Durga? Why worshipping Durga? They want to get financial capacity, all nice, you know, prosperity of this human life, I mean family life. That's why always Durga worshipping. In Chandi, Chandi is one part of Chandi Sukta. You know, there is Vedan. There is two parts, Agam and Nigam. As for Nigam, you can get this Shukta from Veda also. Shukta of Devi Shukta. Shukta means, I mean, recitation of in Veda. So highly, Durga, how coming? Durga is a shadow of this Jogamaya. But still, people are running whole world. They are praying. If you hear, you know, this morning time, before Devi coming, they recite Mahalaya. It is called Mahalaya. They recite Devi Shukta. They always crying and speaking. Dhanang dehi, janang dehi, jaso dehi, disho johi. Why? This way they are singing. Oh, you know, give me all property. Dhanam dehi, dhanam means riches, property. Janam dehi, give me manpower, money power. Dhanam dehi, janam dehi. Yasho dehi, fame and name, position in this world. And, oh Mata, kill all my, you know, enemies. Try to kill them, finish, so that I can enjoy Sovereign Unity. Dhanam dehi, janam dehi, jasho dehi, disho johi. This way speaking, all the time. This is the reason. Yesterday, that's why I told, they are all karmi. They are all karmi, infinity pure. For infinity pure, they are running, running and running. Still, they are not going to stop any demand from heart. They are all karmi. I already told. And those who are going to do everything and going to avoid result of that karma, they are gani. I already told, Prabhupada speaking, both of them, they want to make Supreme Lord their servant. Give me, give me, give me. In everywhere, in this material world, always you can find. In Veda also, different demigods there. Dehi, 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 dehi. Give me, give me, give me, give me, like beggar. Like beggar. They are always asking, give me, give me, give me, give me. And Vaishnava, what speaking? Take you, take you, take you, take away, take away, take away. Hey, Prabhu, take away. Even my clothes you can take away. This is the difference between Vaishnava and material people. Vaishnava always speaking, oh Prabhu, you take away. All hazard, big problem. You take away everything, no problem. I don't want anything. Follow. This is the basic difference between Guru Vaishnava and material people. At all there is any opulences, anything, they like to utilize all property and riches for the seva of Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan. All the time. This is the target. Only target in their life. Now, yesterday I was discussing Nehavikkamanashosti Pratabhayo Navidvate. You need not get any feedback. I am going back little bit to give you a reminder. Actually, this sloka already I discussed, but still I come back to give you a reminder. Nehavikkamanashosti Pratabhayo Navidvate. You are not going to get any bad result or, you know, feedback, because salpam api asyo dharmasyo athat karma yoga. Karma yoga is almost, if karma yoga is perfect, it is oriented with bhakti yoga. Because until and unless you have devotion, I already discussed yesterday, who is there? Who is going to do anything without any purpose? Without any motive? Without any motive, you like to do anything? Who like to do? In Shastra it is written that mandadhir opi na pavartante prayanam anuddisho. Prayanam anuddisho mandadhir opi na pavartate. Without any reason, even those who are having less intelligence, those who are less, they also not like to do. Before doing, what profit? What I can get? Hey, you go to that temple. There is any bandara? Then I can go. Others I can go. They like to take information. Without any interest, no. Only I give you example, though you are right to put this question in front of me, Maharaj, without any reason, why people can do business? Why people can do this, that? Why? Why? But I can show you, there is so big, big sadhus, those big, big, you know, devotee, they are doing business, they are running kingdom, king, big, big. They are all doing for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Their ultimate goal is to seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. That is the life. Follow. Those who are habituating, they are not habituated. Anything they are doing, they expect result. But already Krishna speaking to Arjuna, that is what the only fault. the only fault there with you, that you are always thinking that you are going to kill somebody. That is, a doership is the only cause of your bondage. Follow? In your life, your doership is the only cause, basic cause of your bondage. Try to leave this false ego that you are doer. Who are you to do? In each and every fraction of second, Krishna giving momentum, Krishna being energy, Krishna giving power to recite me Harikatha, to come here. Who am I? If Krishna would like to stop now, now I have to stop. Who am I? This false ego you should discard, throw away. Doership is the only reason for your bondage. That's why Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, you see, at least those people, they cannot do anything without any purpose. At least they should try to, you know, give karma phal to Supreme Lord. I know they are not habituated. They cannot do, but still they should get habituated. Karma phal should be. Oh Prabhu, I am doing this karma phal. And at all you are going to get some benefit? Oh, it's like prasadam. Follow? Like prasadam. Yudhishthira Maharaj thing, all this riches, everything is a prasadam of Krishna. Even the crown is a prasadam. Even the crown there on the head of, you know, Yudhishthira Maharaj is also given by whom? Given by Krishna. Yes. So all prasadam. Uddhavji is thinking, all prasadam, even what cloth I am wearing, all ornaments, all tilak, all the residue of tilak, I am doing tilak. All everything. So all and everything, prasadam. Those who are having this kind of conception, that everything I am getting, all prasadam. My arrangement to stay in this nice room, it is also one kind of prasadam. All prasadam. If you can have this kind of concession, then you can get respite, otherwise not. So for common people, the scripture giving advice, at least you try to practice karma fall. That day also I told, yesterday I also told, karmani vadikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. You have the right to do karma. You have no right to take fall, karma fall. You have only right to do. What result you get? That's up to Supreme Lord. Why you are playing your head? That's mean you have doership you have in your mind. Katitva abhiman. You have the doership, paurush. In Sanskrit we say paurush. Katitva abhiman, doership. I am the doer. So actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna wants to stop this kind of conception. Because this kind of conception is going. And actually, if they are habituated to this system, I mean karma arpan, anything you do, I am doing for Krishna, for Prabhu. At all it is you are habituated, then this kind of system, procedure is called almost bhakti. Whatever you are doing, if you are doing for Krishna, it's automatically bhakti. Follow, automatically it becomes bhakti. So, quite natural, salpam api asya dharmasya trayate mahato bhavet, it's quite natural. Because in Gita, Krishna already told, Prabhupada, bhakti, everybody say, if bhakti in this life, you are doing little bit, still this amount of bhakti going to stay with you. Even after death, that can follow. That bhakti you cannot destroy. Of course, if you are going to do some mistake, aparad, unto the lotus feet, dam, nam, vaishnav, then it is different. Then you can lose your consciousness. How you can know, how you can understand that you have done some mistake? that gradually you see, you cannot feel that consciousness going down. You don't like to do harina. Ah, yes, harika, mom. Okay, I can go that day. This way consciousness can drop. Then you can understand, must be there some aparad. Aparad can, by due to aparad, you can lose your consciousness. That is the main thing. That is the main thing. So, salpamapi asya dharmasya, athat karmarpan dharmasya, dharmasya, this salpamapi asya dharmasya, trayate mahatobhayat. Naturally. So, mahatobhayat, what do you mean by mahatobhayat? I already told. Mahatobhayat means, you are going to do some activity, have some desire, so according to that you are going to get result, life after life. That is danger for you. Because in karma, there is, in karma, karma is not dangerous. Try to understand this vital thing. Karma is not dangerous. But your expectation, result, you want, that is danger. Karma, if you can do with good mood, very nicely, even fighting, you are fighting, righteous fire, you are killing, but you have no doership. I am bound to do because I am Kshatriya, I am engaged in this, so I will have to do to protect my country. So if you are going to kill thousands of people, still sin is not going to touch you. You are not going to incur any sin. Follow my point. So in karma there is no danger. The danger is there that you expect something out of that karma. That is the technique of karma yoga. That is a very fine technique. Whole life, if you can apply this procedure, scientific procedure, which Krishna is going to advise to Arjuna, if you can remember and apply in each and every step of your life, then you can. Even after killing so many people, Yudhishthira Maharaj, Arjuna, they are not going to incur any sin. Bittasur. Bittasur taking birth. After that, Bittasur is touching the cloud. As hair tips touching the cloud, so heavy. At the bank of Narmada, Bittasur running, Bittasur fighting. Why? There is so many reasons. I already told. So, this life, Bittasur must fight. Follow. So, going to kill Indra. This is all demigod. Bittasur going step by step. All people under his leg, trap. But Bittasur having no doership. Even at the last moment when two hands cut, Bittasur with mouth open, going to fight. But still, when Bittasur speaking all Bhagavad Dharma, Indra gone mad. Indra says, oh my God, how possible? You are demon. Come on, you are demon. How possible that you are speaking all Bhagavad Dharma Tattva? Jad vihayo asura bhavam mahapurushatam gataha. Jad vihayo asurik bhavam mahapurushatam gataha. How possible? You are demon. But you are speaking all Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, as it is. I feel shy in front of you. I am the king of heaven. I am demigods, but I have no, that kind of, you know, Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan I don't have. So I am very surprised to see you. Oh, Bittasur is giving to advice. Oh, Indra! After that, Bittasur speaking to Shankarsan, oh Prabhu, ajata pakshaiva matarankhaga. This slok, I can discuss someday. Oh, I like to go to you, Prabhu. I like to go. I am crying like one baby without mother, helpless. One small bird, depending on our mother. When mother can come, give some water and, you know, fruits. There, waiting. Chee, chee, chee. Always chipping all the time. Crying when mother can come, depending on mother. Ajata pakshaiva mataram khaga. Batsotara khudarta. Batsotara means one calf crying to meet mother to take milk from, suck milk from breast. Piya pyevo bhushitam vishanya. One newly married or lady love crying for his, you know, lover. It's long distance, there's gapping. She cannot leave or he cannot live without. It is there in Meghdut Kumar Shambhav, one very nice kavya written by Kalidas. In material world, Kalidas is the topmost kavi writer. Material world. Topmost, Kalidas written. Even in MA class, BA class, they are reading. You have to read, it's a must. So nice, you know. There actually it is written. Very nice. Priya Pievo Ushitam Vishanya Manaha Me Didikshatam. Hey Prabhu, my mind is like that kind of trouble I am facing. I am feeling pain, I like to go to you, I like to meet you, Prabhu. Please accept me. This is conception. So you see, still, so Bhittasura is going to fight that way, but still, Bhittasura is not going to take any trouble. Because Bhakti is there. What is the feeling of those devotees? Pashupakki hoye thaki swarge va niraye tabo bhakti rahu bhakti binodhi jay. That is the conception in extract of Bhagavatam. All devotee, hey Prabhu, you can send me a locust, you can make me a beast and bird, I don't care. But please arrange bhakti inside me. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, that's why writing this way. I don't care, Prabhu, if you can send me according to my activities, you can send me to, I can become birds and beasts, no problem. Pashupakki hoye thaki sharge in heaven, but niroye. Niroye means hell, heaven and hell. It's all the same for me, because if you give full bhakti, I don't care. Bhittasura also crying, hey Prabhu, I am going to travel life after life. Maybe you can arrange my bhakti. Nothing else, I want nothing. So a devotee is staying in hell or heaven all same. Because bhakti is there. Bhakti means nectar. Nectar is there, so no problem. I already told you, Gopal Das, the elephant, initiated by Rasikananda Babu, feeling very, he is elephant, but still feeling nectar, bhakti. Always serving all devotees. There is big bandara going to take wooden, dry wooden log without any price. Going to go down anybody. Who is going to check elephant? Taking all the wheat packet and everything and throw. Who is going to check? Oh, elephant coming up. This way Gopal Das, up to his last moment, used to serve. After leaving body, all Vaishnava making big procession in the name of Gopal Das. Ah, Jai Ho Gopal Das. So, I already told in Ayodhya, long ago when I was a student, that time I heard that there was one Hanuman monkey. Used to hear Ramayana every day. Every day the Hanuman must come and stay in front, in backside. Everybody hearing Ramayana from this elevated soul, big sadhu, Ramayana. Hanuman hearing. After that, Ramayana is over, going back to tree. After leaving body in Ayodhya, this is the case in Ayodhya. You can go and ask. I've been to Ayodhya also. Because I had some friendship with Ramayana Baba. This is a big, big sadhu. There, Sarujuna, the Ram Janmasthan, long ago, not now, I am not going. Never. I don't like to go. That time, long ago, maybe 18, 20 years back. So, you can go and ask them that Hanuman, when living body, all big bandara, big procession, with big procession, with Ram, Kirtan, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. They are going kirtan, procession, and going to Saroju Nadi. And they give Jal Samadhi, water Samadhi. After they come back, and a big bandara, thousands of people taking prasadam. So, devotee in the form of elephant, or because bhakti is a natural function of soul. So, no problem. So, Hari Bhajan, any people can do. Any people from any part of the world, they can come and start Hari Bhajan. Hari Bhajan is possible, provided they are sincere and honest. So, this way you see, Pashupakki hoye thaki sarve ba niraye tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinodahidvaye. That is the expectation, that is the prayer, that is the apple of any devotees in front of Supreme Lord. So, actually, Vittasur is not going to get any result of karma because he is out of jagga coming, doing anything, everything. Huh? After that, what he needs to do, he is doing. But inside, bhakti is full of bhakti. So, salpamipi asya dharmasya trayate mahato vayat, karma, if you do perfectly, is not danger. But the result you are going to expect, fall, karma fall, that is the danger. So, mahato bhayat means you cannot understand. This karma fall, what you are expecting, this can put you down and down and down. You cannot, what is danger? You cannot understand. But you are very intelligent, you go on thinking. You go on thinking. That's why Narottama Thakur writing, why writing? Punna se sukher dham naloiyo tar nam. Never try to do kirtan. Never. You never try to do this kirtan. But how, where from you can get feeling? Narottama Thakur writing is kirtan. Oh Prabhu. Punna se sukher dham naloiyo tar nam. Oh Prabhu. I am not going to take the name of pious activities because I can get some result out of this. Punya se sukher dham, because punya, the pious activities can put me in heaven, higher planet, then I can get habituated to stay in planet. If I am habituated to stay in heaven, follow what I say. If I am habituated to stay in heaven for long period, how I can stay there in this material world? All those rich men, if they are habituated in AC all the time, how they can suffer when the temperature going to 45 degrees? They cannot do. That's why Narottama Thakur speaking, Punna, I don't like to speak the name of Punna. Because Punna, pious activity can put me in trouble, more trouble. Why more trouble? Punna se sukher dham nalo yotar nam. Punna mean, I can go to higher planet, I can get habituated. If I am in heaven, then I can get habituated to play with Apsara. Those who are heavenly, there are Apsara there. Apsara, you know, they are playing. Very nice girl there. I can get habituated. This kind of is very bad. After that, there is no disease, no sweat, nothing. No, there is nothing here. Sargamin, all the time you can feel cheerful, fresh. No disease going to touch you. If I am going to be habituated there, how is possible if you throw me in a poor family at the bank of one canal, very poor man, and there's no heart, no system, no breath, nothing. How I can live? So Northumbrago speaking, is if I am habituated, then I cannot bear. So it's good. I don't like to take the name of pious activity. Better if I can do some, you know, evil activities, I can go to hell. In hell, I can get heavy punishment, heavy punishment, heavy punishment. After that, I can get nirved. I can get some detail. Oh, so much punishment I am giving here. I cannot do anymore. Oh, Prabhu, I cannot do anymore. So in this respect, hell is more better than heaven. Because at least you can, this life, can check yourself. Oh, I was getting so much punishment in jail, this, that. Oh, so many. So now I can lead nice life. Somehow you can check, take decision. So even in big, big jail, you can go. The jailer, they arrange harikatha for those, the prisoner. You know? Nothing? You don't know? Yes! Those are prisoners, big, big prisoners. For them, the jailer, pious jailer, arrange harikatha. Sometimes they call sadhu, speak harikatha in front. They are inside prison, they are speaking harikatha outside. To change their life. Yes. So you understand what is the, where is the mahato bhayat, what is the great danger? Why here, trayate mahato bhayat, what is the danger? That is your karma fall, you are expecting some karma fall, that is the main cause of your great danger in future. Tayate mahato bhayat means, if you are habituated to leave everything in the name of Prabhu, karma fall, if you are going to leave everything, then at least you can save yourself. So, after that, I was discussing about Babel, next slogan. I already discussed that day, I can touch only. Babasayatika buddhiri kehab kurunandana bahu sakahi anantascha buddhayo avavosainam. Those who are getting babasayatika buddhi means nishchayatika, their mind is settled down already. Settled down means, if they are doing everything and anything and everything for Prabhu, that is one kind of bhakti. There is bhakti. So, if they are habituated, nishyataka mini, nishyata in Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, if I do Krishna bhakti, then everything done. Krishna bhakti, Krishna bhakti kahile sarva karma krita hai. That is called Nishyatika Bhakti. The day you can feel, if I do Krishna Bhajan, then everything finish. I need not discharge my duty for family. Follow. I need not discharge anything for country or society, anything. Actual Bhakti. Not that pure Bhakti when you get. Then all duty finish. Krishna bhakti koile sarvak karma kita hai. If I do Krishna bhajan, suppose somebody like to go for bhajan. Like I can discuss, if I get time, Madhvacharya I can discuss. Madhvacharya took decision to leave home. Narayan Bhatta, I can discuss. 11 year only, small boy of 11 year. Madhvacharya didn't think it necessary to take permission from Vedavati, Mata. Name of mother is Vedavati. Father is Narayan Bhatta, South India, Paja Khetra. Follow? He didn't think it necessary to take permission. Who is mother? Who is father? Huh? Who is mother? Who is father? Fly, go Rajatpur and took sannyas. Achyuta Prakhya, 11 years. So this way actually, Madhvacharya not going to discharge any duty for father and mother. society, family life, nothing. Ramanuja is also sending wife to home. You go. There is an arrangement of marriage of your brother. Go. After gone, fly and take sannyas. Leave everything. So this way, actually, Vyavasayatika Buddhi means whose brain, already intellect, already settled down. He already settled down, he already can understand, realize that if I do bhakti, I mean, then everything can be done. Those who are karmi people, this is not the case for them. They have their, you know, intellect running in different branches of their intellect, multiply, wait, running here and there. So naturally they are restless, because Krishna Bhakta Niskamatev Shanto. Who is Shanto? Who is tranquil? Who is enjoying full tranquility? Who is peaceful fully? If he has bhakti. If he has no bhakti, then no question of tranquility. Where from that gate? They are restless, always, you know, planning program, they are going on in brain. They are restless. Their mind is not settled down. Follow? They are always thinking. In Bhagavat also Krishna speaking to Uddhav, yato sadhro ya mat karmasu nirvinno sarva karmasu vedo dukhyatmakano kamano paritagena upi anishvaraha. If somehow can get some interest in my katha, jato saddho mat kathasu, at all he has some desire, but anyway, somehow, luckily, somehow he hear harikatha. Oh, it's very nice. So he feel interest. To come again and again to hear Harikatha. Follow? One family of thief, you know, follows discipline, his, you know, father, grandson, they are all thieves. Meaning they are, yeah, their income. Father stealing, grandfather stealing, they are also, this is their system of income. Follow? One time, grandfather going away from material world. I mean, going to leave body. Grandfather call everybody. All grandson and son, everybody come to me. I have some last advice to you. What advice? What advice? You see, we are thief. We are running our life this way. We have no technique how to steal from house, this, that. Please, you promise you all, never try to go for good association. You promise me. Satsanga, don't do satsanga. If some of you doing satsanga, then we cannot run our business properly. Follow? We cannot run our business properly. We are running hereditary factor. We are. Be careful. Never try to do satsanga. Satsanga is dangerous for our income. You promise? Okay, grandfather, we promise you. We can never go for satsanga. So where is satsanga? They run away. Yes, there's satsanga. Grandfather, I promise, no satsanga. But one day one problem happened. What problem? Night time they are stealing. They are stealing from some house. Successful stealing. Operation is very successful. They are coming with all ornament, everything. Everything. Somehow, somebody could realize. Follow. And so, they somehow try to escape from jungle. Jungle, you know, there is thrown everything. Very dense forest. Sometime before, you see jackal shouting outside. This kind of problem. So, they two or three, their brothers, and they are running fast. But somehow, they hearing some harikatha over mic, very nice harikatha. One sadhu speaking, well, how to? They then put luggage here, somehow tight, and put two fingers here. We don't like to hear Harikatha. If there is Harikatha, big problem. We don't like to hear Harikatha. Somehow they are checking their hair organ and running. And somehow they are coming to a, such a forest where there is full of throne. So they put leg on throne. Oh my God, were they? Open their hands and try to check throne. Then in the meantime, 5 or 10 minutes, they hear enough Harikatha. So that kind of Harikatha is very powerful from a very high sadhu, high class sadhu. So they are not going to run their business anymore. They come back, we cannot run our business. Somehow you hear Harikatha. So Harikatha can give you this kind of facility. So if you are going to get any interest in Harikatha, that is good system. Though there is some desire inside, okay. You have some desire inside your heart, still go on hearing Harikatha. Very shortly you can find, discover, all problem gone, finish. Akamo sarva kama va moksha kama udarati tibreno bhakti yogena jajeto purusham param. Hena? Is there? It's nice in Bhagavatam. Akamo sarva kama va moksha kama udarati tibreno bhakti yogena jajeto purusham param. Okay, no problem, there is desire, full of desire. There is no desire. Both of you, both group, are requested to worship Krishna. I am not going to stop your worshipping. Don't misunderstand me. I can give answer after this Harikatha. Worship is good for Kali Kal because I can explain. So, you see, somehow you would develop interest in Harikatha. It's good for you. So, Vyavasayatika Buddhi mean they already settled down their mind. Okay. We have one channel. Brain is going through one channel, not different channel. So, this kind of, you know, people, they can get some advantage. Those who are having branches, they are restless. When they can come out successful, we don't know. Brahmando bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev guru krishna prasade bhai bhakulata. So they were happy. While traveling through 14 worlds, someday they can come across with a sadhu. Somehow they can develop interest. Then brahmando bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev luckily. Brahmando bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev guru krishna prasade bhai bhakulata bij. Not a matter of joke. Not a matter of joke. Sadhu Sangha, not that you are getting, oh Maharaj, Sadhu Sangha very, no. Whole world crying for Sadhu Sangha. Those who are realized a little bit. Those who are foolish, in the name of Sadhu Sangha, they are doing all evil association. That's why this is the condition of devotional field. So cheap at present. I'm sorry to speak. So now actually, 42 I already told, this slope, actually you should remember, yesterday I couldn't get my time to explain. But I was speaking this way, jamimam puspitam vacham prabadanti abhipaschitaha vedavadarataha partho nanyad astiti badinaha. Nanyad astiti, are nothing is there after this life, useless. Like Charvak, you know. It's useless. Enjoy yourself. This is the formula of whole life, whole world. But jamimam puspitam bacham prabadandiyo avipaschitaha. Those who are not actually intelligent, they're always running behind this puspita vachaha. Mane, there is a nice garden. What is a garden? In the Vedic culture, Vedic, you know, in Veda, there is different kind of lucrative offers. If you do putreshtu yogyo, if you can do putreshtu yogyo, you can get baby. Putreshtu yogyo, you can get putra. If you can do jis yogyo, you can get control over human being all. You can become king. This way, different kinds of jagya and ritualistic activities, different kind of jagyas, different kind of ritualistic activities is, is going on in different family. If you have the chance to stay in any family, any Hindu family, you can stay anywhere, any Hindu family, in South India or in North India or Bengal, anywhere, they have some, their hereditary system of some ritualistic activity, some speciality. I mean, you are inherited, we are bound to do it. This way we are doing. So if you stay in any family, you go and stay, one or two nights or 1 month, 2 months, you can say they have some, oh, today is our Lakshmi Puja, Lakshmi Puja. Kali Puja, next day of Kali Puja, next day of Kali Puja, this is Durga Puja. This is Durga Puja. After that, after 15 days, Kali Puja coming. So next day of Kali Puja, somebody worshipping Lakshmi Puja. Because that time after Sagar Manthan, Lakshmi came out. Nobody knows. That is a Tithi. So you don't know. You are foolish. You don't know the system. They know. That's why they worship Lakshmi Devi. Follow. This way they are doing. So some ritualistic activities are there, always everywhere. Any family in India, Bharat, those who are actually Hindu, for them. So everything, they have some hereditary practice of some ritualistic activities. So, in Veda, different kind of lucrative offers are there. So it's Veda, it's written, so you must do it. In Veda it is written, so we can do it. This way, in Veda, different kind of offers are there. But in Bhagavatam, I already discussed, you can remember. In Veda, of course, there is different kind of lucrative offers. For whom? For those foolish people. Those who are really intelligent, they think it is given to guide those foolish people. Follow? To guide these foolish people. To guide these foolish people gradually. If you are going to do fast operation, they can die. They can leave everything. They can fight with you. So slow operation. Veda doing very slow operation. Now, you can take meat. You can take cook meat, but not now. When you are doing jagya, then after doing jagya, sacrifice then in that Jew. At least you are having some control. Well, I cannot take meat now. I have to do jagya. There I can take. This way actually, woman association, everything, all controlling. To give birth to baby, only association. Or other time, woman association, greatly sinful activities. You can get heavy punishment. In Veda it is written. Only to give birth to baby. This is the system, written in Veda. Not for other purpose, not for enjoyment. Then you can get heavy punishment. So this way, those who are not having sensual control, they have no control over their sense. So at least in Veda, some rules and regulation, Vedas are going to attribute, Veda are going to attribute some rules and regulation, impose some rules and regulation on them, better something than nothing. Better something than nothing. So they are going to put rules. So gradually they are habituated. In his Bhagavatam, 6th canto, it is written to guide them properly. It is spoken there to guide them. Nibritastu, nibritat. Nibritittastu mahaphalam. Ultimately, gradually, Veda going to do some operation, going to impose some rules and regulation on them, so that they can get habituated to get control over their sense organ. Today or tomorrow, I can show them in day what is the last goal of Veda. You see, Supreme Lord, there. That is why gradually I guide you. Like one small boy, mother tried to give him bitter medicine. Oh, I cannot take. If you take medicine, I can give you sweet ball. Is there? Hey, give, give. No. First of all, you have to take sweet. If you do read this book, after that I can give you this toppy lozen. Always I can. Give, give. No. After first you recite this, read. A small boy, no, don't like to read, don't like to eat. If you take medicine, then I can give laddu. To stop crying is one kind of procedure to make fool of you. To make fool of you. Veda speaking this way. Ultimately, what is the goal of Veda? To show you, see the Supreme Lord. Vedasya sarvai rahame babedhya. Krishna speaking, hey, if after reading whole Veda, if you cannot see me, Jagannath, foolish. Your reading Veda is all idiotic activities. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Vedasya sarvai rahame babedhya. Hari, after reading whole Veda, you cannot see where is Krishna. I search and I go through whole Veda. There is no Krishna. I go through Bhagavatam, there is no name of Radharani. Foolish number one. For foolish people. This is the system. So, jamimam puspicha, jamimam puspitam bacham, prabadanti avivaschitaha, vedavadarataha partho, nanyad astiti badinaha. Those foolish people, they are running behind this lucrative body. Oh, I can do it. I follow this system. This is that. This big. Even there is so many system in Veda, so many. Avisha system. If they like to kill you, they can kill you. There is so many tantric system. So many things there. But for that, Veda never like to show you that procedure. Tantra, mantra, avisha. Atharva Veda was created after. First, Riksham Joju. Atharva means there is a procedure, so many dangerous procedure. Application. But those who are doing full devoted soul, for them this tantra, mantra, black magic cannot do anything. Nothing. If you are full of bhakti, your life is dedicated for Krishna, who can do what? You know? Who can do what? Asatama running one Brahmastra, who can do what? Can do nothing. Krishna is the protector. Then, so those who are foolish people, they're saying, hey, useless, there's nothing is there after death, you go. Yes, there is written, I can go for this kind of activities, I mean, what is prescribed in Veda, and get this kind of result, no problem. Follow? No? Very nice. Oh, nothing is there. After death, who is going to see me? They cannot understand. The Atma, soul is perpetual, eternal, they cannot feel. From this feeling that Atma is not eternal, even Mayavadi think Atma is single Atma. They think single Atma. At this reflection in different water pots, you know, countless water pots there, same sun you can get reflection, that is foolish number one. In Bhagavatam it is written, all Shastra, countless Jivatma. Countless Jivatma for countless period, running, traveling. Sometime you are my father, sometime he is my father, she is my mother, this way, traveling. No respite. The reason why? Doership. If you can't cut this doership and show submission under the lotus feet of Guru Vishnu and Bhagavan, danger all over. Finish. They think those who are busy with this ritualistic activity which is prescribed in Vedas, kamatmanah sargapara janma karma phala pradam kriya vishesha bahulam bhogai sarjagatim patihi atev tara kamatma. They have some or other kind of desire inside their heart. They sometimes desire, okay, this life I can enjoy riches. After next life, after living this way, again I can go to heaven. There also I can enjoy. Heaven. But it is written in Veda already. Heaven is not permanent place for you. Like if you go to any five-star hotel, I been there because one devotee was in from America. An accident. My Guru Maharaj ordered me, you go and take information. What is they give me news? I went there. 5-star hotel there in Alipur. When is red cloth? That time I have red cloth with pagri. Somebody saying this Vadu coming inside this reception. Where you are like to go? I like to go this room to meet that devotee. Oh, you go. And that devotee, without asking me, give order for sarbat, beverage, fruit juice. He don't know I am not going to touch it. He ordered me. That time, long ago, it was 700 rupees one. Sarbat, this glass. It's for you. I said, Prabhu, I already took a lot of water. I am lost into it. I cannot take. You take it. Oh, you cannot take. I can feel sick. That's why I come to see Ramdas Prabhu only. Where he is in hospital. So I can take you, surely, Woodland Hospital. So after some time, I sit somehow, very carefully, in this 5-star hotel, then come out and take one taxi, go to that hospital, Woodland Hospital, take information and go and give report to Guru Maharaj. To carry out the order of Guru Maharaj, I was there in 5-star hotel. You see, where billions of dollars you have to spend one night, one, you know. This way, they are having, and not only that, that he is from Singapore. He is the manager of Singapore office of that man, Ramdas, who meet accident, car accident. He taking me by car, follow. And I meet that devotee, going here and there. Within 2 hours, he is taking fruit juice 3 times, stopping here and there. One Muslim people meeting with, Prabhu, Prabhu, you can take. No, I am actually not thirsty, you take. 3 times within 2 hours. So attached with body. Oh, I am feeling so problem. But I am not feeling any problem if you put him in the scorchy sunlight, 40 degree, 50 degree. Very nice, no problem. So it's a question of habit. Within 2 hours, he is standing 3 places. In Park Circus, in Big Shop, he is taking fruit juice. Prabhu, you take. I am actually 30, I took a lot of water. What to do? This way. So you see, his name is Sridhar. He took Harinam from Guru Maharaj. I am laughing. He took Harinam from Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj previously never wanted to give initiation to anybody. After that, everybody forced him. But no, I cannot make disciple. Whole life took decision. No. So, atoyev, see, kamatmanaha sargaparaha. They have different kind of desire. This life, all riches, enjoyment. After living this life, they like to go to heaven to enjoy a facility, enjoyment. They are available in heaven by his. He should know that heavenly planet they are going, that enjoyment you cannot get for a long time. Like I told, 5-star hotel, one night you will have to pay 50,000 rupees. One night. So in heaven, what kind of price you will have to pay? That you are doing some pious activities, in this life. So you like to go to heaven? So all pious activities is one kind of deposit, check for you. One kind of, you go to heaven, you have to give this check to Indra Maharaj, the heaven. So if this money amount is over, then they can throw you again this material planet. Follow? That is why Krishna is speaking, Khine punne mattolokham visanti. Khine punne mattolokam vishanti. Khine punne. Seventh case ending. Punno khaye. Punne khaye. When punno going deposit, your punno deposit, pious activities, all the result of pious activities going to be finished, like for 5-star hotel. If you are not going to pay money next morning, they can throw you. Go outside. This. Heaven is also same. If you like to go to heaven, it is up to you. If you can take choice, you're going to go to heaven or go to Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. If you like to go to heaven, you have your choice, you can go. And after your deposit is over, they can throw you out from heaven. And throw again. Kine punne matta lokam vishanti. Again, you will have to come back in this material world. Again, you will have to come back in this material world. No respite. So you see, kamatmanaha saragaparaha janma karma phalapradam. Janma karma phalapradam. Kriya vishesh bahulam bhogai sajyagatim pati. So, janma karma phalaprado bhogai sajya bhog and enjoyment, different kind of riches, they have the mood to get it. Prapti, sadhana yuvato, they are doing this kind of ritualistic activities, pious activities. In Vrindavan also you can go, some set coming, giving banana to all monkey. And why they are giving? If they know, if they feed monkey, somebody feeding and wheat to prison. Prison mean, you know, this? Pigeon. Somebody giving some rice, everything to crow. There's some procedure there. They're doing why? They know today I give to crow, I can get result. Without any result, not doing. Even sometime I'm doing mono parikrama, I don't speak. Oh, countless parikrama, I used to stay there in Govardhan. Some said coming, Baba, Baba, take it. You keep. I cannot speak. I run. Somebody giving indication, take kambal from me. So I go. I know they are doing why? To get some result. This way. So this way they are going to enjoy and they get to get some, you know, facility. That's why they are following this kind of procedure. So by this procedure, fruitive activities they are doing, so anyway they are going to get fruit. And Krishna going to advise, next I can go up to this sloka to discuss. Bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam taya pahita cetasam vyavasatvika buddhi samadhau na vidiyate. Bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam. Those who are very much attached to this kind of enjoyment, everything, bhogai sarjo, riches and enjoyment, bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam. Prasaktyanam mana? Asakti mean affinity. Prasakti mean tremendous activity. Pro. Paro. Pro, para, apo, onu. This kind of prefix. If added with one's word, then the power of that word increases. I already do. Changes. Word. Meaning changes. I already told, no? Prahar mean beating. This dhatu. Prohar. Har dhatu mean beating. Bihar mean traveling. So this is changing. Ahar mean eating. Arey Maharaj, same dhatu, same root, but meaning changing. Ahar mean eating. Bihar mean traveling. This way meaning changing. Follow. So you see, bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam. So not asaktyanam, it's prasaktyanam. It is written prasaktyanam. Prasaktyanam, tremendous affinity. Not asakti, prasakti. Tremendous affinity. So bhogai sarjo prasaktyanam, taya prahita cetasam, their, you know, intellect, their buddhi, their, you know, thinking power, gone. All stolen. By whom? By this demand for desire, enjoyment, riches. Bhavasayatmika buddhi samadho na vidiyate. They can, not at all, they can settle down their mind. Bhavasayatmika buddhi samadho na vidiyate. Because they cannot settle down. Samadho means settle down. Samadhi means no movement of mind. Samadho. They cannot get this. So, Vyavasayatmika buddhi samadho na vidiyate. They cannot get. So, now Krishna speaking, "Ho Arjun, it is my advice to you. So it is my advice to you, see, Traiguno Vishaya Veda Nistraiguno Bhavarjuno. Ho Arjun, Veda is going to cheat you if you are not intelligent enough. Ultimately Veda is going to show me. Ultimately, surely Veda is going to show me. But for not from foolish people. So I am bound to speak you this way. Traiguno Vishaya Veda. Veda is going to show you some procedure through which you can get conflicted by three modes of nature. Follow what I mean to say. Automatically, you can get conflicted. So, Traiguna Vishaya Veda, Nistraiguna Bhavarjuna, Arjun, I am going to advise you that you don't become hypnotized. You should settle down your mind. You see, don't look at those who are running wrongly. So, Traiguna Vishaya Veda, Nistraiguna Bhavarjuna, hey Arjun, try to go beyond this conception. So at least if you can go out of the influence of three modes of nature, Traiguna Vishaya, Nistraiguna Bhavarjuna, Nirdanda means equipoised position. Nirdanda means equipoised position, balanced position. Standing on this mutual position, you can feel no trouble. No material nature can put no influence on you. It's called equipoised position. Nirdanda means dando in Sanskrit, you can dando samas, you know? There are different kinds of samas. Dando samas also. In Bengali, bhalo-mondo. Bhalo-mondo. Is good or bad, is Dvandva Samas. It's called Dvandva Samas. Samas is different categories of Samas. So Arjun, Nirdvandva, try to go up to that point where you can feel no trouble. Because it is a duty of Prakriti to put some influence on you. So why you are going to get influence? Why you are going to be influenced by Prakriti? That is my question. So, Nirdanda, equipoised position, Nirdanda, Nitya Sattvasto, and Sattva-gun, Shuddha Sattva should come and acquire your heart to put you in a very peaceful position. So, no amount of trouble can put you in trouble. Follow, what is it? Nirdando nitya sattvasto niryogo khema atmabanaha. Niryogo khema atmabana mean Arjun, those people, those who are living in this material world, be careful, try this scientific evidence I am speaking. If you fail to digest, big problem. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, see, those material people, you can remember, those material people always thinking, today I make this building, okay. But I will have to shift to Bombay, Juhu. There also I take one flat, so I have to stay there. So I will have to also maintain Mayapur flat also. So this way I have to maintain, so I can engage. So they are always busy, what amount of money they already have in their life, and what they are going to get in future. Both their mind is always running, how to check the previous amount I already acquire, properties, everything, to maintenance, and what I am going to get in future, all they are busy with the maintenance. Follow? That's why, nirjogo khema atmavana meenaha, mean, what do you mean? Nirjogo khema, would never try to think about the maintenance of what you already have, what you are going to get, or maintenance you are out of. You are playing your head, all taxes and problem actually, and actually income tax official coming, oh my God, going to do Govardhan Parikrama, oh Giriraj, actually next Monday actually income tax officer coming, please help me. Is this bhakti? I know myself, one rich man is doing business of a gold, income next to our house. previous home, not here. They actually, that, you know, he is getting lot of gold. And all income tax officer raid coming to check up. He put all gold inside oven. Oven. Oven means not this gas oven. That's when kacha oven made up. Cooking going on and putting gold inside. Maybe 15-20 kgs gold inside. Oh my God. In Kazakhstan, we have right information that you have gold. Where is gold? Well, actually, you have wrong information, actually, officer. Wrong information, but we have no wrong information. We can check up everything. Check up bed, everything check up. After that, fine. We like to check up this oven. No, actually, it is cooking. Throw. After they find lot of gold there inside. Inside oven. Yes. One black marketing man. He is going to the border. Border. Bangladesh border or Pakistan border, maybe. That's not a big important. Practical. It's not a story. That they are the security officer, they are testing by machine. The gold is there. But where? Whole car search, bed, everything, cushion, all of that, everything. But there is nothing. They are failure totally. After they say, but we cannot allow you to go, you will have to confess where. We can allow you, promise you, we can allow you to go. But you will have to speak where. After that, it was known that he make the nameplate golden. After that, black color making. I mean the car plate, nameplate. Name, I mean the number of car. That was made of gold. It is made of gold, made, fix up and make black color. Follow, this way people, yes. Somebody with water taking golds. Like medicine. After that they pass tool and after that they... yes! 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 100%! 100%! This way actually, those are black marketers, they are running their life. So, you see, practical, I am not speaking any story. So, nirdando nishatto nittos, nirdando nitto sattasto, nirjogo khem atmaban. Atmaban bhi, you try to look inside your bone, soul. Inside, yo, don't try to look outside. Material people, they are always busy to look outside. But the tattvagyani, they are running to road here and there, they are always looking inside. They are not looking anything. You can check up. Those who are tattvagyani, they are running like you. You are also going here and there, he is also going. But his side is also inside. But your side is outside, looking. Outside. Get some color and design, everything you are watching outside. It's the prasad kripa of Durga Devi. Follow, you see. It's the kripa of Durga Devi. So this way. So you cannot pass away the influence of Maya. So strong Maya is. So nirdando. No, actually, in 45 slok, Traigunno Vishaya Veda Nistraigunno Bhavarjuno Nirdando Nitya Sattvasto Niryogo Khem Atmabana Atmaban. This way, Arjun try to leave all this kind of conception. Go beyond it. Try to go beyond the influence of Prakriti, Machar. Then you can understand what I mean to say. Arjun, then you can understand. You cannot understand because you are busy with this kind of. So it's a big problem. So actually, 46, you know, it is written, Javan artho uda pane, Javan artho udo pane, sarvatoho sang pluto dake, tavan sarveshu vedesu. Brahmanasya vijanataha. Oh Arjun, like you have a small pond beside your house. There is no water facility. But you are in fix. you are in problem. Because sometimes you are washing your clothes there in pond, but you cannot collect drinking water from there because the pond is very dirty, small pond. I've been there long ago, 22 years back, in Midnapur, one place, Bar Bhagavanpur. My Guru Maharaj have some Jagannath Mandir there. Still they are running, actually. My Guru Maharaj got this temple for somebody. Kenaram. He got this temple. There, even today, Bar Bhagavanpur, from Kathi you will have to go. Bar Bhagavanpur, this place. Jagannath Mandir. I've been there for some reason. One time. For legal case. Because they don't know. I will have to go and help them to meet the jailer. I mean, not jailer. I mean, a district magistrate. That's the idea. I go there. I stay. Where is water? Drinking water. Probably you have to drink it. Huh? Yeah. I cannot drink. Small pond. From there, collecting water, cooking rice. They drink. Say, I can die. I cannot stay. I want to fly from here quickly. After that, they spend 1,50,000. Still, water is not good. Still today, some such places there in North Bengal, here, there, South Bengal. If you spend 2 lakh rupees, still you are not sure that you can get nice water. Not sure. You can waste your money. So sweet water you can go. That says there, Krishna giving argument. Arjun, suppose one small pond is there beside your house. So you are going to do some, it can serve some purpose. At least you can wash your utensils on, you know, clothes. Okay. But all purpose you cannot, this pond cannot serve all purpose. So Krishna giving this kind of argument. Nice. Arjun, think over and again. Javan artho udo pane. If there is small pond, what utility you can get? But if we are going to get a big lake, then water is always purified by sunlight. So from there you can get drinking water. You can take bath. You can wash your leg, everything. The Bhagavan Sri Krishna getting. So those who are going to get this kind of stand with this kind of argument, I mean small lucrative attitude, they are actually going to fulfill their purpose. Follow. They are going to worship Durga, they are going to worship, you know, Ganesh. They are going to fulfill their purpose, little. But if one Brahman is very clever, he can do Bhagavad Vasana. Bhagavad Vasana meaning? Just now I told you, na? Huh? If you do Bhagavad Vasana, Vishnu Vasana, you can get all purpose you can serve. Akamo sarvakama, I just told, na? Eh? All purpose. All your requirement can be fulfilled. No need of running here and there, you see. If you can take the actual meaning of Veda, inner meaning of Veda, if you can understand, then you can depend on Krishna. Vedeshya sarve rahame vavidya. If you can feel it, then all purpose you can serve by devotion unto the lotus feet of Vishnu, Krishna. Javan artho udo pane sarvatoho sankpluto dake tavana sarveshu vedishu brahmanasu vijanataha. Then after that 47 I can finish today. At least if you have any question I can give answer. Karmanyevadhikaraste Ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phalo hetur ruhumate sangastu akarmani karmanyevadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana ma karma phalo hetur bhumate sangastu karmani. Hey Arjun, you have the right to discharge your duty, karma. You have no right to think about what result you can get out of that. That is dangerous. Because foul result you can get. oh, I am going to give you this kind of argument, for that you can think, okay, I cannot do anything. No! You see, Arjun, I am giving this kind of argument, so you can take decision not to do any, better I cannot do it. No! There is karma, akarma, and bikarma. I already discussed. Karma means, which is prescribed, karma, akarma, bikarma, three kind of things. Karma means, what prescribed in Veda you will have to follow, that is called karma. Nitya naimittik karma you can get. And akarma means, what is prescribed there in Veda, not, you are not going to follow it. You stop it, I cannot do. Follow what I say. That is called akarma. Akarma means, not doing what is there prescribed in Veda. So karma, akarma you understand. Karma means what is prescribed there in Veda. Akarma means not prescribed there but not doing. Not doing, that is akarma. Not doing what is prescribed there. And bikarma means, bikarma means viparit karma. What is not written there in Veda, what is written there in Veda, you are not following. Okay. What is written there, Veda, you are not following, you are not going to do. Okay. But it is called akarma. But bikarma means, what is written, prescribed there in Veda, you are doing just opposite. Follow? It's called viparit karma, bikarma. So it is called bikarma. Bikarma means, what is written there in Veda, better you don't, we are not doing. But you are doing just opposite. So it is called bikarma. Bikarma opposite. What is not written there in Veda, you are doing all rubbish. Follow what I say. What is written there in Veda, you are not doing, you are doing all rubbish. It is called bikarma. So karma, akarma, bikarma, three kind of prescriptions there. Hey, three kind of things there, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying. So Arjuna now can take decision. Okay, you already speak this kind of thing, so I can take decision not to do anything. Krishna, no, you will have to do. You will have to discharge your duty. If you take decision, what is written in Veda, I cannot do, it is not good. You will have to do your duty. It is also bad. What is prescribed there in Veda, if you are going to follow accordingly, is good. If you are not going to follow, it is bad. And to do just opposite, it is more bad, still bad. Follow what I say, understand. So karmanyevadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachano ma karma phalohe ma karma phalohe turvamma ste shangastu akarmani vancha kalpadurvasya ke basinde bhavcha patitanam pavana bho vishnabhyo namo. So up to this point 47 you can stop. So in Kartik I can discuss something. Now I am going to answer your question. Yesterday you think I am going to stop your worship. Don't think that way. Those Guru Varga, they arrange. I am giving answer to him. Now Gita stopped now, up to this point. Karmanyevadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachanam. Actually, I am not against worshipping. My Guru Maharaj very much in favor of worshipping. But though Guru Maharaj's worshipping is like in Yogopitha or somebody can think Guru Maharaj also worshipping Siddha Mahatma, but his worshipping is totally different from your worshipping. His worshipping is just like in Vrindavan, Dibbat Binda, and you know, Kalpat Drumada. There he is worshipping. Your worshipping, as per prescription, it is written in Shastra, Prabhupada also speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that worshipping is oriented with your material body and mind. Some spiritual matter is also going to be developed gradually, but still, material things also. So Archon is a Kanishta Adhikar, but this Archon we cannot stop. Bonded soul cannot engage themselves in Seva. If they stop worshipping, if they stop doing all this kind of activities, they can become ideal. They have no power to do Harinam, 1 lakh Harinam, perfectly. At all they are going to do 1 lakh Harinam, they can do some Namaparad. This is very dangerous. They can try, but to engage those bonded souls, or our Guru Varga making this temple. One side, to engage them in Seva, those who are coming to Math. Another side, for preaching purpose, Math is very good. But of course, if there is character is there, all big, big sadhus staying there, they have realization. Otherwise, this preaching center is useless. I am not speaking. Bhaktivinoda is speaking. I am not speaking. You cannot charge me. Bhaktivinoda is speaking. Oh man, oh gentleman, if they are going to open big, big spiritual center, if they are going to open big, big spiritual center, and those members there, they are all bonded, so they are doing all rubbish all the time. So Bhaktivinoda was speaking, outside people coming, watching it, they can spit on them too. They cannot get bhakti. They can become very angry. Oh, they are sadhu. They are red clothes. They are sannyasi. They are leading their life this way. Rubbish. They can hate Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. In Bengali Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, you should translate all this book very quickly. Otherwise, no scope. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Bengali speaking. Rajastama Tarute. Rajastama tarito kichu baddhajib ganer dvara sthapito je adhyatik patishthan, spiritual patishthan, they are all bonded soul can stay, they can do all rubbish day and night, outside people come to take benefit, but instead of benefit they can get feedback, they can express their hatred, they can spit on them. Bhaktivinoda is speaking, I can show you. So, Mott in one sense very good. All our Guru Varga, Prabhupada, doing why? To engage you in Seva. Whereas, Mott Mandi Dalanbari Nakara Poyas. Who write? Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Krishna in Gita, Krishna in Bhagavatam already speaking to Uddhava. Man Mandir Karay Dhiram. You can make a big temple. My temple. Temple. Mot purpose is different and temple is different. Mot mean where all spiritual students, those who are coming to get some benefit. Mot mean Motanti Basanti Paramarthinaha. Those who are paramarthik. Those who are coming to get some knowledge, get some training, they can come and stay in mud. Under the guidance of spiritual leader, who is perfect, not cheater, then they can get training, do some seva. And mot mean, there are some pujari can stay, some brahman can stay, they can run temple. Mot mean preaching center. So I am not against worship. I am not against worshipping. But you will have to keep your health okay. When you are suffering, any pujari who is defective bodily defective means one hand handicapped, you know, one eyes is not there. One finger is not there, they cannot worship. You don't know. If is some bad smell coming out of his mouth, cannot worship. If his teeth is very black, Sanatana Gosai speaking, you cannot give initiation to them. Sanatana Gosai writing. Disease, full of disease. Not curable disease. So to worship deity, you must keep your health okay. Even I am bound to speak. Suppose you have taken prasadam 1 o'clock up to this point. Very nice prasadam. 1 o'clock. You have no right to open temple 3 o'clock. Because still indigestion you are there. Oh, you can speak. You have taken prasadam? Yeah, no digestion. Until and unless full digestion, you cannot go. Be careful, nobody is going to speak this way. You have to maintain very like pure Vaishnava, Brahman. Brahman, Vaishnava means already Brahman covering. So pure Brahman, very, very light prasadam which can digest within that time. No wind and nothing. Yes. Very nice, solid, full health. Then you cannot sip. So many. But you cannot sip anyway. You cannot, if you are sick, he cannot sip. If he is sick, she cannot sip. But you do or sip. Or sip is very good. Even in Harinam Bhajan, it is prescription I can discuss. Those who like to do Harinam, for them, in Narad Pancharatra it is written, I think, I forget. Jeno janma satair purvam vasudeva samarchitam. Jeno janma satair purvam vasudeva samarchitam tan mukhe harinama nitishta divarataha. Those who are worshipping Krishna life after life, birth, only they can do harinam. So you cannot avoid worshipping. I am not against worshipping. I am speaking unnecessarily. You arrange, after that you cannot do. I am sick, I cannot do. Why you arrange then? That I am speaking. Don't misunderstand. Don't try to misinterpret. Try to follow what I mean to say. So here I like to stop. If you have any question, you can put. Follow? Any question? No? No question? Okay. What question? What question?
He was saying we should go inside instead of just doing outside, you know. We should go inside ourselves. So my question is, how could we go inside?
I am answering. I am giving answer all the time. Satsanga is the best possible way. Satsanga is the best through which you can concentrate. You hear me? You can do success in your education if you hear Gita. 100% I promise you. Because automatically your brain can concentrate. You can. Within 2 hours you can read what other student can read 5 hours. I promise you. I know. You can get an extra backing to control yourself, mind. Follow satsanga, nothing else.